Welcome to WebStylePress. If you are new here, consider subscribing and hit bell icon. CSS Float property specifies how an element should float. Should it float to left or right? CSS Floating is important and can be used to quickly shift an element to left or right side. Floating can be used to place items with each other without using grid. You can create grid by using CSS floats. Although you should be careful when you float elements, always remember you need to clear float after you use it. For example, if you use CSS float for few elements before using more elements, clear float and then use new elements after that. Otherwise, elements can overlap each other. Floating elements kinda become layers. Floating elements are like layers. CSS float is important subject in front-end development and you should master it. We have this regular HTML page, a CSS file is linked with it, and also Twitter Bootstrap via CDN. I want to have two elements, one at left side and the other at right side. Inside this container, left, and this is right. For CSS, left and right. Float left. And right float right. Save. Watch CSS. Save the document. Refresh page. And inside container, float left, float right. Now let's use some more elements. Container wrap. I have got an image. This icon.png. Let's use a paragraph. For CSS, wrap and img. Right now output is like this. As you can see, overlapping is already happening. This is image and this is the text. Let's float image to left. Margin fifteen pixels to right. Refresh. This is our container. And this is our first container. Inside first container we have got left and right, two floating divs, and there the second container that is overlapping, and you can see elements are overlapping. To solve this issue, use clear both. After these floating divs outside of it, clear. Clear. Clear both. And let's use some margin. Margin bottom 20px. So clear both will solve the problem. Now these containers are separate because of this clear both. And this image is floating at left side. So text is besides it. So this is kind of, this is column 1 and this is column 2. So this is kind of a grid without using grid by using CSS Float. In this tutorial, more than float, I wanted to show you this clear floating issue. I will not recommend to use floats, CSS floats. Now we have CSS flexbox and CSS grid and we do not need floats. Bootstrap 3 used CSS floats and Bootstrap 4 and onwards is using flexbox and CSS grid in future maybe. But you will have to handle code sometimes that will be using floats and you will have to deal with it. So here you go. This is an important subject and if as a team lead I will interview you, I will ask about CSS floats and clearing floats even when it is not encouraged to use it in modern frontend development practices. Okay, give this video a like, subscribe to channel and press bell icon. Stay tuned and I will see you in the next video.